the wing nuts, and then just make sure everything's connected, and then basically you turn it on to the frequency that you want, adjust the gain, which basically widens or expands the kind of the direction you're shooting, and you just kind of hold this up and try to pick up the signal and zero in on where the frog is.
Chris Schopp is searching for these little creatures. It's a pine barren tree frog. It was named North Carolina's state frog in 2013.
Ideally, we'd like to get a visual without being disruptive. So if it's buried down under a sphagnum mat, unless it hasn't moved from that spot in a few successive tracking events, then we'll just leave it be, mark that spot.
The little tree frog gets its name from this, the habitat it calls home, the longleaf pine ecosystem. It's also called the Pine Barrens. The wetland areas of longleaf pine forests grow moss, ferns, and other plants, and it creates an area that is too acidic for most amphibians, except the pine barren tree frog. Trouble is, the longleaf pine ecosystem is disappearing. It's being developed.
This species here has disappeared from a good portion of its range in North Carolina.
And it's difficult to protect a species when not much is known about it. So, researchers at the North Carolina Zoo are tracking the pine barren tree frog to learn more about its habitat, its range, and what it needs to survive.
We decided we were going to do a telemetry study and look at the movements, how they're utilizing their habitat, what sort of factors influence their movements, whether it be fire, whether it be proximity of water.
And how do you track a little frog with a really little frog-sized tracking belt?
The transmitter itself weighs about the weight of an aspirin, so about 0.3 grams.
20 frogs were outfitted with tracking devices. The batteries last 40 to 50 days. Trackers go out 3 times a week. Tree frog telemetry is just one example of the expertise of zoo staff in the science of animal tracking. Here's another. This is Ziggy. She's a year and a half old black vulture. And if you look closely, you can see the transmitter on her back. The GSM GPS transmitters use cell phone signals, which are less expensive than satellite tracking systems. And zoo researchers are using these devices to track vultures in Kenya and Tanzania.
It has a little backpack, so it goes around her wings and then sits on her back. And you can see that antenna that comes out on the back so that we can get a good signal from it.
The transmitters send out data once a day, showing locations and flying altitude. Several months of tracking data reveal the birds cover almost 125 miles per day. That information is critical in developing a plan to protect the birds, which are vital for a healthy environment.
They are nature's cleanup crew. So they're out there eating dead animals. They actually have really acidic stomachs, so when they eat something that's died of a disease, they process and get rid of that disease so they can actually remove things like anthrax from the ecosystem.
The technology may be changing, but the science hasn't.
So by having elephants with collars, you're getting more accurate information about where the herd is, and it makes it a little bit easier to monitor them.
The zoo has 15 years of experience in animal tracking, starting with elephants in Cameroon. Researchers recently added Nigerian elephants to their list. Zoo staff and local park rangers are learning more about the elephant's land requirements. The tracking system also alerts rangers when elephants stray from protected areas.
So rangers are trying to track the elephants so that they know where they are before the poachers do. In addition to poaching, the other big problem elephants have is they sometimes move out of protected areas into people's farms. So by knowing where the elephants are, we can see when the herd is starting to head out towards the border, and then the rangers can go out and make sure the elephants stay in the park and don't cause conflict with local villages.
Back to the tree frogs, zoo staffers have found that telemetry only goes so far.
When we put these transmitters on, followed them around, we found that they weren't moving as much as we kind of thought they might. We also found that it was really kind of difficult to find females. The males we can find by their call.
Sometimes you need to go old school to find the frogs.
And we would stand out there and try to get them to call back to us. And I can do the call for you best I can. Probably an insult to Pine Barrens tree frogs, but it usually works if they're out there calling. So kind of what we do is kind of something like this. We usually work in teams, and we'll go out there and kind of try to triangulate where they are. So one of us will go on the far side, one of us will go on the other side.
Conservation is a critical part of what this zoo is about. So we focus our conservation efforts both on North Carolina species and also on animals in Africa, because that's what we have represented here at the zoo. And we think it's important that not only are we giving people a chance to learn about animals, but we're also helping to protect the relatives of these animals out in the wild.